between the UAW and the automaker and to vote on it. Corinne Rose talked with members of UAW Local 2209 before today's midday session.
There's some very good aspects to it and some things that aren't quite so good.
UAW Local 2209 members streamed into meetings to learn about the tentative four-year agreement with General Motors and vote on the proposal. UAW leaders who sat at the table with GM negotiators presented the information.
The people inside that are up there leading us have the answers. And if they don't have the answers, they'll find out the answers. And that's what's important, being informed.
Many members had already read details of the contract online and knew how they wanted to vote. One of the main points of contention had been, and continues to be, how temporary employees are treated and paid.
The existence of the temporary workers is part of why we were able to stay open years ago, and they're contributing significantly to the bottom line. So, you know, the idea that they're not going to be brought on board sooner than 3 years is problematic. I think that would be a major sticking point for a lot of people.
We get so much because of this union. We get, you know, our benefits are great. We get these bonuses. The temps don't get those. You know, they don't get the bonuses and all the benefits that we get, but they work their butts off for the company to make these profits. If it weren't for those temps, that plant would not run.
Temporary employees who've worked at GM for 3 years will be hired in permanently on January 6th. The proposed contract also includes bonuses of $11,000 for every worker if the contract is ratified and $4,500 bonuses for temps. However, the contract allows GM to close three plants, the Lordstown Assembly Plant in Northeast Ohio, dozens of those employees are already here at Fort Wayne's plant, as well as transmission facilities in Baltimore and Warren, Michigan. Local union leaders say that's because GM wanted to produce products overseas.
They're taking the Chevy Blazer over to Mexico, and we got products going to China being announced as late as, you know, last week, new products going to China when American workers could have done that work just as good, if not better, here in the States.
The 4,500 members of Local 2209 form the largest workforce in GM's North America operations and have until noon Friday to vote on the proposed contract at the Union Hall. Corinne Rose, Fort Wayne's NBC.
All right, thank you, Corinne. And nationally, the UAW wants all votes from across the country turned in by 4 o'clock on Friday. If 51% of the total membership passes the agreement, it will be ratified. Results are expected to be announced Friday evening.